Okay, this is going to be for Libra. If you're not a Libra, you could apply this to your seventh house. Guys, feel free to like, share, follow, comment, subscribe, reach out for a one-on-one reading. So this is dealing with the homestead, relationships close to home and or near and dear to you. This is using your crystal ball, your crystal vision, seeing things through the lens of wisdom on your travels when you are out and about, revising things when you have a second to think about them. Especially when it comes to areas in your life that you don't feel are growing or being conducive to long-term stability. Okay. Yes, taking things personally, but I feel as though that you're at the healthy benefit of zooming out when you need to zoom out, not trying to rush things. Like, for instance, I've been experiencing a lot of network problems with my cell phone. I ran out of mobile data. I'm supposed to get more today, but it's taking forever and a day. And energetically, I'm at the point where I'm wanting to turn out a lot of content because I just have a lot of energy and a lot of things to say. But of course, the mobile data is not working. Now, I could bang my head against the wall and be frustrated, or I could just zoom out and say, hey, let me focus on what I can control, which is recording as much content to my heart's content, and then I'll just upload it when I have more mobile data later on in the week. So that's an example of like zooming out, right? Don't butt your head up against the wall and be frustrated at the things that you are able to be frustrated at, but really remain open-hearted to zooming out and maximizing your energy potential by zooming out and seeing the bigger picture, seeing what you can work on and affect positively here and now. Now, it could be that you want to follow some sort of regimen or protocol or tradition that makes things more rigid, but you're being asked to redistribute your energy in a more kind of useful, effective way that can knock out some of your goals that you're currently trying to work on. But I feel as though that this is actually going to be a fun adjustment, and it's going to help kind of catalyze this kind of major shift here. We're talking like high masterclass, like black belt level, seeing the perspective. You have every right to be angry, mad, and upset, but you are still choosing to be unaffected and be better for it. That is, you are better than any negative entity that you encounter. Because at the end of the day, that's your choice, right? And you can stand tall in the confidence and the love that resonates with that choice, as opposed to like being doubtful and feeling guilty that you are combative with the ego. No, you can choose a higher, broader perspective that works in your favor. I'll give you another anecdote. I do deliveries on my electric scooter. I have this green Uber Eats bag, and some people, you know, they like to smirk and smile and they think it's funny and they laugh at it, and I could choose to be hurt and take it personal, or I could, you know, choose to be unaffected and be better for it. You know, that is to say, I'm unfettered, I choose to be unaffected, I choose to be happy, whole, and complete anyways, you know. So in this realm, we have a lot that plays off of our ego, but you can choose to just be happy, whole, and complete and just focus on that and your positive momentum. And I think the point of that is that I feel as though that you have this big hunch, you have this big inclination that a breakthrough is imminent. You know, you're on the precipice of this. So I think you're feeling really good about that. All right, guys, I could go on and on. I'm going to leave it here. Love you guys. Reach out for one-on-one. Peace.